Clark given more heed to Yuin's views, the savage battles of Casino would probably never have been fought, and the venerable house of St. Benedict would have been unscathed. Rudolf Böhmer, 1st Fallschirmjäger Division, 1944. Start deployment. So we will place Rommel's Tiger Force at the far back and start the battle. Fuck, I am in control of them. I thought I had placed them under AI control. So, alright then. And we have to pause the game. They will probably, they can't retreat, alright. Then we will do this. We'll use the infantry against their infantry. And of course the BMW motorcycles are good too against the infantry. Alright. We will also use tanks. All right. You don't even need to use the planes this time. So the land troops are moving forward. Infantry. Here are the North Africa Assault Corps. Only recruitable from Africa, yeah. And the BMW motorcycles and the tanks, mostly Panzer I's. Their infantry is about to get blitzed. So my troops are good against the infantry. Certainly to my benefit that they didn't have any planes in this battle and no tanks either. They were protected by the hills too. Panzer IVs here too. Infantry has reached the SS infantry and the North Africa Corps. Alright. I'm tired of this battle. Send some planes against them as well to speed things up. All right, an easy victory. Statistics. 75% enemies killed. Continue battle. So we can kill all of them. Or they survive. anyone to survive the battle. So they can regroup and form new armies. Use the command ability. And we won the battle! Awesome! Men deployed, Erwin Rommel, 398 men killed, 475, very good, 396 left, remaining of the battle. Enemy army, Captain Vladimir, 475 men, kill 0, and remaining 0. And the stats sticks. Alright. Japan is operating in the Pacific in the hope of extending her hold over New Guinea. From such a position, she could carry out raids on Australia whilst awaiting our final defeat by Germany, General Alan Brooke, 5th May 1942. Alright, we defeated that army. And lost a few troops. Of an SS unit will be moved out for now. They will move back there. Can't attack them this turn. This army could move out. Not with their best units, alright. No more advance there in the east. What about these troops? No. Alright, we've already moved these troops then. We can look at the construction then. Probably are constructing in most places already. Alright, we have a medium caserne we can build in Minsk, or a small tank factory, or a mortar training ground. We'll go for the medium caserne first. And I believe we are already constructing things in most places. We're back in Berlin. Look at the recruitment. We're still constructing the Tiger, 50% completed. So we'll look at other places. In Oslo we'll get another assault infantry as usual. And in Minsk we can now get Messerschmitt and Stukas. But I will not do that because I feel like we cheated there for a while, so we will get a spy. All right, in Brest, nothing. An assault infantry unit in Vienna, and in Copenhagen we'll get an assault infantry unit. There we're Berlin back in Berlin again. We're still blockading this port. Let's speak to the Soviet Union. Left-click on the listed offer and demand items to create map information. Map information. A balanced or very generous treaty. All right. So we have their map information. Regions all the way down here. They are far from defeated. And here we want to attack Portugal. It might irritate Spain. If they attack us, we will have to kill them too. even though they are an Axis friend. Or we will send a diplomat there, but I don't know where my diplomat is. We need a new diplomat, probably. Because one of the diplomats is in Helsinki, far away. Maybe we'll remove him from there. Try to go towards Spain. The other one is going to Africa soon to try to reach the United States over here. Alright. Next turn. Alright, end of turn report. We are still plus in economy. Construction report. We have a large concern in Warsaw. Construction complete. A large concern in Warsaw, yes. Recruitment report. We have the new Tiger 1 in Berlin. Frankfurt, we have a Panzer 4. In Vienna, we have Assault Infantry. München, we have Panzer 4. Hamburg, Panzer 1. Copenhagen, Assault Infantry. Oslo, Assault Infantry. We have Messerschmitt 109 in Rouen and Amsterdam. And we have Stukas in Paris and Brussels. We have a Panzer IV in Prague. Panzer I in Bordeaux. Panzer I in Warsaw. Panzer IV in Stettin. And a spy in Minsk. The Turkish army is once again moving around here in Europe. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. French Republic, Bulgaria, United States of America, Bulgaria. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. Thailand, the British Commonwealth of Nations, French Republic, Hungary. Alright. We are moving the diplomat into this place. British Commonwealth of Nations. Speak with them again in case something has changed. Map information, map information. That's all we want from you. We give it to you too. Alright. So Britain has taken quite a few areas from Thailand here, but have failed to conquer India as of yet. This is the map over here in Europe. We have Portuguese armies here. One unit there, another unit there. Alright, so our army has reached the border. In Portuguese territory with the main force. So Lisbia, the capital. I wonder what type of settlement it is. So a Spanish army here, quite big one too. Riflemen, scout snipers, Messerschmitt 109, so they have the same planes as we do. Italian Empire diplomat there. Alright, we won't move anything more. Need defense there after all. Move a plane there too, to defend properly. A plane to Paris. Right. We don't need a spy that far away now. Let's move her closer to the border. They huge army marching on us here. T-34, 85, 23 missile, 26. Total defense experience 3. T-34, 85. I don't know what their stats is, what the stats are for that one. All right. Lots of armies, full army here too. Let's move this army down there to face it. Alright. Alright. Tiger One has arrived on the battlefield. Another plane there. We have a new assault infantry unit reaching Brest. So we'll attack this army this turn. Should be able to win against that army. Right. Panzer 1, 2 could be moved there. Stokes Mortar could move it there too. I need a new general. He might die, that's a waste for general. So we have planes here, tanks and planes. They decided to fight. Then we will let them attack again. They won't move out. Full army there. I guess we will defend again the city. Won't move them from Brest. We need them as a garrison. So let's start the battle instead. Alright, save the battle. It is. Save the game before the battle. Alright, glad it's armored to be controlled by the AI, yes. Start the battle. Won't even try read all that in time. Foggy battlefield, let's wait. Wait. Start deployment. A huge tank army here. Lots of Panzer IVs. Freshly arrived from the factories of Germany. Same with the Panzer Ones. It's clearly a tank army with some planes borrowed from the other army. They needed some planes. to not be entirely crushed when the Soviets have planes. Alright, let's group all the tanks into one group. Loose formation and group them. Alright, and then the planes in another group. And loose formation. And then the mortar. Mortar could be there on the hill. Firing at will with loose formation. Alright. Start the battle. Pass the game. So we have another army arriving here. A great army. Not a full-sized army. Or fully-sized army, but still a great army. It even has the new Tiger Ones. A really good tank. It has arrived on the battlefield here. Alright. And some additional planes. Now we need to find their armies so we can order our troops to attack. Okay, we will start with the Messerschmitts. They will of course attack their planes, their MiG-3s. Alright, and then we have a bomber. They are not good at against that type of unit, unfortunately. So I think they will be sent towards that bigger tank, the T-34-85. Look at it, it's pretty huge. It's a bigger turret than the T-34. Here are the MS-1s, light tanks, and then the T-34-85s. Really powerful. Alright, no ordinary T-34s. Send the Panzer-1s towards their MS-1s. Alright. Light tank versus light tank there. Alright, and then the... This is a T-34. Well, this is a T-34-85, I see. Panzer-4s are slightly better than the T-34. So we'll send them against these guys, then they have the T-34-85. It's better than the Panzer-4. But it's worse than the Tiger One. I believe it has the same projectile as the best American tank and as the Mouse. But it has lower armor than the Mouse. It has the large shell, while the Tiger has the turret turret barrel one ship projectile. Alright, we send two Panzer IVs against the T-34-85. And we have some motorcycles we'll send against their infantry here. And some more tanks. Send them against their infantry. Steamroll there. We had a lot of tanks this time. All right. And that's it. I guess we'll send this against the T-34-85s too. Alright. T-34-85s. Yeah. New York. Here comes the Panzer Corps. Panzer Force mostly. Look at the Panzers. Some Panzer Vans too, and some mechanized motorcycles there. Battle has started. My tank army is facing off against the Soviet army. Their T-34-85 upgraded T-34 tank. They're even stronger than the Panzer IVs. How funny that they arrived about the same time as our Tigers arrived. Air battle in the sky. We have a lot of planes too. And then we have the second army coming here. Some planes, but mostly tanks. Some infantry. And the new Tiger ones here. Only available from Berlin currently. Because it's the only city where we have upgraded the tank factory enough. Large projectiles of these Soviet tanks are being unleashed now. The general over here with the BMW motorcycle. Just move them into AI. See what the AI will do. We lost quite a few of our tanks already. Lot of planes, which is to their advantage. We seem to be leading this.
Unsere Männer haben den feindlichen General erschlagen.
Seem to be leading currently. Seem to be beaten. They seem to be beating our planes. Which is some infantry still advancing. So if they defeat our planes, our tanks are in a bad situation. We have another army coming, including these tigers. Right. Yeah, enemy general fallen. Continue the battle. Captain Constantine dead. So we won the battle. They seem to have routed and retreated from the battle. Yeah, they did retreat. No wonder we had total numerical advantage here, numerical superiority, thanks to the Second Army. Otherwise, I think they might have won.
Das Reich hat seine Überlegenheit durch diesen Sieg bestätigt.
So we won the battle. Great. So Gunther Alterbung had 434 men, killed 414, so killed almost as many as he had, has 318 remaining. Captain Wolf had 324 men, killed only 4, men remaining 324, so the Second Army weren't really in the battle. Enemy Army Captain Constantine of the Soviet Union had 596 men, killed 122, probably mostly tanks, so pretty good, men remaining 162. Alright, in the detailed statistics screen. And then return to the map. I hope it won't crash. In case opportunity for destruction of a major portion of the enemy fleet is offered or can be created, such destruction becomes the primary task. Admiral Chester Nimitz, in his order to Halsey prior to the Battle of Leyte Gulf, October 1944. Didn't crash, awesome. Continue expanse, Gunther Alterbung. Alright. No infantry there. Let's merge these troops then. The tigers will be added, as will the rest of the tanks. Can't allow such luxury units to be there. Could keep one plane for that unit. Or I changed my mind. We will have all the planes in this army. So, Gunther Alterbung is ready to march. Couldn't march a lot too. Alright. We don't need 4 units of BMW motorcycles. Add a tank instead. Alright, so Gunther Alterbung is ready to march towards Kiev. Alright. We have a second army here. Then we had an army over here as well. That was stupid. Alright, we'll do this. So the enemy had 2 armies. We have the General Nikita Stalin, probably an armored officer's car, yes, machine guns. And then they have 3 plane units with full size, 2 MiG-3s and 1 Yak-9 fighter planes. And then they have three additional planes, one Jack 9 and two MiG-3s and some infantry, so they had lots of planes. While we do not have as many planes. But we have Rommel's entire army. Let's fight the battle in the battle map. On the European front, the most important development of the past year has been the crushing German offensive against the great armies of Russia. President Franklin D. Roosevelt, 29th April 1942. Start deployment. Let's move Rommel himself and his tigers back. Alright, start the battle. And lose formation. So we are reinforced by this army. Let's move Rommel here. So our planes have arrived. We have quite a few planes, but most of the army is, of course, made up of panzers. And then we have, of course, some infantry too. Some of the best infantry. The North Africa Corps. Panzer IVs here. Only very few of them. Most of our panzers are Panzer I's here. Rommel himself has Tiger I's. He will not partake in the battle unnecessarily. He will be at a safe distance. So the Soviets had lots of planes in this battle, but not much else. We had a bodyguard and some infantry too. The bodyguard is okay, but it's as good as a BMW motorcycle. But the infantry is worthless. Problem is they have the advantage in planes. They have more planes than us. Good, the army has showed up. It's now ready to march down upon the enemy. Soviet Union. Alright, wonder when they will start to march. So over there are the Soviet Union and their army. Planes. Modern roads here. Some Soviet infantry. Units of infantry. Let's fast forward the balance of power. Victory is a distinct possibility. Percentage allies kills represent, percentage enemy kills represent. Let's just fast forward. I don't have time to wait. army is moving down the hill. Hope they won't get stuck. Rome usually won't get stuck, but can take its time sometimes. They may be waiting on other units to show up. Will usually reach their target at the end. Forward. Actually, I will retreat. Rommel. That might make them move. I don't want him to die.
Welch schändiger Tag! Unsere Männer fliehen von der Schlacht!
If they don't move, I will restart the battle. Because then we can't finish it. I don't want to, you know, lose the battle without them actually fighting. They seem to be stuck. Yes, we'll have to restart the battle. Ah, something is happening now. The infantry showed up there. So this is maybe the first time I have been forced to exit a battle because the AI got stuck. There's a high risk that it would happen again in the same battle. We will try play it again too. Alright, I give up.
Diese Niederlage drückt auf die Herzen aller, die da.
They, the Americans, are, I think, a bit unwarrantably cock-a-hoop as a result of their limited experience to date. They are setting about it in a realistic business-like way, a feeling that they will do it. Air Vice Marshal Sir John Slasher, 1943. I don't accept that result. Alright, load the save. Casualties many. Percentage of dead not known. Combat efficiency, we are winning. Colonel David M. Shope, Tarawa, 21st November 1943. And activate the script there. I wonder, is there no winter all of a sudden? Alright, try again. Same battle. The only words I spoke to the British commander in the negotiations for the surrender of Singapore were, "All I want to hear from you is yes or no." Expected to put the same question to MacArthur, General Yamashita, Manila, 10th October 1941. Start deployment soon. Alright. Start the battle.
Der Feind hat mehr Männer geholt. Gut. So können wir mehr von ihm.
Nice position to start at. We clearly have the hill here. Let's lose the formation. Or maybe not. So the planes are now charging their troops. Good. I think this time they will actually reach the enemy and fight. We will see, so it's not certain. If the same thing happens again, I will have to let the AI attack me instead. The enemy will have to attack them. So their planes are closing in on our planes here. The MiG trees. Yeah, they are firing at our planes now. So there will be a battle. Good. Planes versus planes in the skies. Where are the rest of their army? They are coming. Good. They clearly have the advantage in planes. We have an army. We'll see what will win the battle. Even more planes. Yeah, they have the numerical advantage in planes. Fighter planes. Where is the army? It's over here, marching back and forth. No, I loaded the save game and the tanks turned out like this. So this happens when I load saves. So fucking bad. The game, unfortunately, fucked up in the last battle, as you saw. They didn't reach each other, and then now when I loaded the game, the turrets are not there anymore. So I guess whenever you load a saved game, the turrets disappear. That means the motorcycles will probably have lost their rider too. No, they haven't, but the tanks certainly have lost their turrets. That sucks. Fuck. So what should I have done? I couldn't accept defeat. I should have controlled the army myself. Then I could have made sure they reached the enemy. But I thought it would be more interesting to watch the AI fight, because yeah, they may do a better job. could place it under AI control when I control it too, but that usually doesn't end up as good. The AI is better when they control them from the start. But now I regret doing that. I mean, I should have just played the battle as normal. Because now most of the tank force is fucking stupid looking. It's retarded. Without the turrets, I mean. Some infantry here, Soviet infantry. Already broken. One unit at least is broken. I wonder how many units ended up without turrets now. Might not just be my troops, it might be all the enemies too. Tanks from all sides. Fuck that. Maybe if I close the game and load it, they will be normal, but I don't really believe that. I believe they will be bugged no matter what. Now when I have loaded a save game. So what I will do is, after the battle, I will save a new save with a new name. Then I will exit the game. And then I will try to load this battle again. If they are still broken, I will load that save. And if they are not broken, I will play the battle and then record it and continue from there, because I don't want the tanks to look like this. But if I have no choice, then, well, then we have a few armies without turrets that will need to be wasted. Fuck, I just destroyed all my cool armies. All of them will look like this now. Same with the enemy's armies. The only way to remove that is when the units are destroyed, and when we have a completely new units that are fresh, then they will look good. But as soon as we load a save game, the existing armies will once again be without turrets. So I believe it's the cause is when you load a save game, the turrets disappear. They are moving back. Maybe they will retreat. I think so. So planes look good too. But all my good looking tanks now look like shit. Almost all. Rommel's army got wrecked. So that's a bug. Load a save game and the turrets disappear from the tanks. So the percentage is allies killed 8%, enemies killed 42%. Well, it's better to have them without turrets than to lose the entire army, so I had no choice but to load. But now I know that I should never load a save game, unless I really need to. Of course, when I end the game, I will have no other choice, but if I play like this for hours, I shouldn't ever load. And instead, I should always control the army myself, so that I don't have to restart it because they got stuck somewhere. So the armored officer's car of the Soviet Union is firing machine guns there at our troops. I will fast forward. Battle became boring when the tanks didn't do what they should have done. Most of the army is just standing over here. tigers are still looking good. The ones I control. Fuck, the entire army fuck got wrecked. So the battle in the sky is still raging. So it's going on still, that's why they haven't done anything about the tanks and the infantry yet. Yak 9s and MiG 3s. Had a lot of planes. Way more than we had. Plane went down. Seems to only have one left. One Messerschmitt 109 left. Against all the airplanes. The airplanes have started to terrorize our other troops, I think. Tanks, etc. I don't care if they are destroyed now. And they look like shit. Army is moving onwards. Let's put it on normal speed. It's fine if Rommel's army is destroyed now. Because it got ruined. Fuck this. Jeeps are moving onwards towards the army. Alright, they might win this battle thanks to their planes. And a miracle advantage in the sky. Have some planes still left. So they are starting to take the lead. 44% allies killed, 59% enemies killed. The meter is turning against us. I have some really good infantry here from Africa. Marched all the way from North Africa. Sucks that the army was defeated like this. With the tanks being ugly as fuck. I wanted a cool battle with turrets and everything, not broken tanks ending up fighting with real stuff. Alright. motorcycles versus the jeep. They have the same type of weapon and health. Health is the same too. At least the Panzer I's looked good here. We had some broken Panzer guns.
All right.
So Rommel's army is defeated. Seven left here, the North Africa Corp. Here they have even more planes flying around. Here's their general, by the way. Alright. Six left here. So our tanks are firing from the hill. Look at those projectiles. Ground.
Unser Feind ist geflohen. Sie werden für diese Schande in der Hölle schmoren.
All right, time to retreat, Rommel. They are being fired at from the planes. We will save after this battle, and of course. Try to end the exit the game and see if the same bug is still there if we load the old save. If it is, we will just load this and continue. So they won this battle. Clear defeat! Your army is Erwin Rommel. 31 men, kill 0. Men remaining 28. He lost 3 and killed 0. Captain Peter. 366 men killed, 268, that's alright. 60 remaining. Nikita Stalin had 97 men killed, 231, that was very good. Because they had only planes pretty much. Captain Nikolai had 313 men killed, 71. Probably only the planes, not the. And the jeep, not the infantry. Killed 71, 110 left. And the detailed statistics. Alright. So I destroyed all the armies there. Sucks. So they are without turrets now, the tanks. And panzers. I should have remembered that that happened with the United States in the past as well. And I loaded a game and then continued the attack on United States, their tanks were without turrets. Erwin Rommel retreated to this city. We have two artillery pieces here. And we have the infantry. We don't really need 5 and 7 infantry units. All right. save the game. Alright, and see you soon.